Shri T. Rangaya.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, Speaker sir, for giving me opportunity on behalf of YSRCP party to speak on the Farmers Produce Trade and Commerce Promotion and Facilitation Bill 2020. I support the bill because it will enable barrier-free trade in agriculture produce. It allows intrastate, interstate trade and commerce of farmer produce outside the physical premises of market yards and deemed notified markets. Earlier, the farmers in India suffered from various restrictions while marketing their agriculture produce. Selling the agriculture produce outside the notified agriculture marketing committee market yards were also restricted. Genuine traders of agriculture produce also suffered due to unfriendly laws of the government. Farmers had to sell their produce only to registered license holders of the state government. Farmers and traders were suffered with the interstate restrictions of the flow of the agricultural produce. Now this bill is a historic and heroic step to unleash the highly regulated markets in the country. Farmers and their farm produce will go to new avenues and farm far away markets without much barriers and get remunerative and premium prices. I hope this bill will prevent distressed sale. We have seen number of times where the surplus produce of tomatoes and onions, potatoes thrown away at road margins. This bill empowers the farmers to engage with the investors of their choice. Private investment, remunerative price, electronic trading platform, dispute resolve mechanism surely will help the farmers. The Kisan Rail has been sanctioned to my state of Andhra Pradesh, particularly from my constituency Anantapur to Adarsh Nagar, New Delhi. I am very grateful for that, both state government and the central governments. These agriculture reforms will surely bring benefits to the farmers as well as the consumers and attract more private and foreign investment in agriculture field, such as the establishment of modern warehouse facilities, creation of the cold storage infrastructure, and such investments in the food and supply chain is expected to increase the farmers' income as well as reduce the waste of perishable commodities. Farmers are very important to our country, and they must be protected. And I strongly believe that this bill will create an ecosystem where the farmers and the traders will enjoy the freedom of choice of sale and purchase of agri-produce. Without farmers, we are nothing. So it is our duty to take care of them. We all need to respect the farmers and their farm produce, just as we respect our soldiers and borders. Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, Jai Hind.
Thank you.